is it, the brand new DJI Mavic Air.
The latest and greatest from DJI, just announced today, January 23rd, 2018.
Very excited to test this thing out. First, let's see what's in the box. Charger, controller, cables for the controller, documentation, propeller blades, propeller guards. Oh my gosh! Holy smokes!
Now, this is my first time seeing this thing in person. It is tiny! It's smaller than I could have even imagined. This is the DJI Spark, the smallest drone that they currently sell. Smaller than the Spark. This is the previous iteration of the Mavic Pro. It's about half the size. Now, there's a lot more to talk about with this thing, but I think first, let's get it in the air and see how it flies. Here we go. This will be the maiden flight of the Mavic Air. Actually, you know, the most important part of flying a drone is to make sure you respect all local drone laws, and you're not allowed to fly in downtown Manhattan, so I gotta... Taxi!
The Wall Street heliport, please.
Now we're in Bermuda. This is the pink sand beach. Perfectly appropriate place to fly this drone. Much more cinematic than New York City's Chinatown, and the drone laws here are much more forgiving. So let's get started. Now, before I fly this thing, some quick technical notes. First of all, this shoots in 4K, but my vlogging camera here only shoots in 1080. So this entire video has been up-res to 4K, which means you're gonna see this thing at its maximum resolution. Additionally, to give a little context to what the Mavic Air's footage looks like, I'm also gonna be flying DJI's other consumer marketed drones, including the DJI Spark, the DJI Mavic, which all things considered up until now has been my favorite drone, and then of course, the Phantom 4 Pro Obsidian. This thing is a beast, it takes my favorite picture, but it's huge. So today is primarily gonna be about the Mavic Air. Now what I'm looking for is a nice level place to take the drone off from. Also, because I'll be flying four drones, I could really use a hint. Hey, Peter McKinnon!
Hey!
We need a spot to take off. All right, this is it, the maiden voyage, the first flight ever of the Mavic Air. Ready, little fella? Wow, is that quiet? That's the Spark you're looking at now. This is the comparison I imagine people are gonna be most interested in. These are almost the same size, folded up. This is a little bit smaller. This only shoots in 1080, so it's a lower resolution. Also, I don't have the controller for this. So I'm actually controlling this using just my phone, which is a total nightmare. My fault though, I forgot the main controller. All right, back to the footage. Ooh. footage is from the Phantom 4 Pro. It's unbelievable. Like, I can't say enough good things about this drone, but it's enormous and it's very hard to travel with. I'm just using it here to show you what it looks like if you're willing to deal with something this size. All right, back to the footage. Hey, no, come back. That's incredible. Incredible. Our initial review, initial response to the flight, everything you'd expect from a DJI drone, performance-wise, control-wise, was comparable to the bigger drones. Obviously, I don't know what the picture quality looks like yet, but as far as flying it goes, it feels like a marked improvement over the Spark and in line with the Mavic and the Phantom 4. All right, and that concludes the flight portion of this DJI Mavic Air review. Now let's take a closer look at the hardware. That'll be easier back in the studio. If I were to pick a word to describe the design of this thing, it would be elegant. The Spark feels a little bit like a toy. The Mavic Pro definitely feels like a first generation product. The Phantom, well, this thing's just kind of bulky and awkward, and other drones on the market, well, this is just unfortunate. Little details, like the way the landing gear folds down off of the arms, the way that the gimbal is sort of built into the body of it. It all feels very well thought out, and it certainly feels like DJI wanted to make a beautiful product in addition to one that works really well. Right down to the carrying case. I mean, this thing is cloth, it's lovely, it feels like it should have a Chanel logo on it. So some conclusive thoughts on the Mavic Air, starting with the footage, which I think is stellar. I think on the Mavic Air, it crosses that threshold of diminishing return wherein the untrained eye won't be able to tell the difference between the footage coming from this or the footage from a much, much bigger, more expensive, difficult to fly drone. There were a couple of minor things about the device that I did not like. The lens cover or gimbal protector on this thing, I couldn't figure out how to get it back on. It was a pain in the ass. I ended up just throwing it out. It's also a little bit awkward to fold. You're never quite sure if you're folding it right. It feels like you might be breaking it at times. And then lastly, to the best of my understanding, this operates off of a Wi-Fi signal instead of a radio signal. Most of the time, that makes no difference at all, but I did notice some range differences between the Wi-Fi signal of the Mavic Air and the radio signal of the Mavic Pro. So that is it for this review of the Mavic Air. I really think that this is going to be a blockbuster win of a device. This is certainly my favorite drone I've ever used. This is going to replace probably all the drones that I use in my canon of hardware to make these videos. Moving forward, this will always be in my backpack alongside my camera and lenses and extra batteries. And if you had told me 3 years ago that in my backpack I'd have a flying 4K camera that takes picture quality this good, I might not have believed you. All right, thanks for watching. I'll see you soon for more technology reviews.